set my timer, my watch. Good morning. I'm Patty Weber. I'm a program director at the National Cancer Institute at the NCI, one of the many, the 27 institutes and centers at the NIH. So the NIH is broken down into those institutes and centers, and 24 of the institutes and centers actually do fund SBIRs. And so at the NIH, the programs are all run kind of differently in each of the institutes. So it's important to not only look at NIH's main website for SBIR funding opportunities, but you really ought to take a look at each of the institute's individual websites. If you're interested in the National Cancer Institute, our website is sbir.cancer.gov. So the NIH Central runs several different programs for applicants, as well as we, actually at NCI, we just started a new program called the Applicant Assistance Program. So if you've never been successful at obtaining an SBIR or STTR award, you can get application assistance right up front. And then they put you in touch with specialists that work with you to develop your specific aims page, and then they'll put you in touch with a program official like myself that can also help with that process. And that actually is one of the most important messages I want to get across to you folks today, is you really need to reach out to the program officials in each of the individual institutes to which your technology might have the best application to apply to. You want to contact us well in advance of those application deadlines. And as you've probably heard, there's three grant receipt dates, January 5th, April 5th, and September 5th. But reach out to us several months in advance. Send us your specific aims page. We are more than happy to review that, give you ideas on how to improve it, because that really is the key to a successful review. Each of your applications are assigned to three or four reviewers at the Center for Scientific Review, but that specific aims page is what the other unassigned reviewers are looking at to get an idea of what your technology is. So that's a really important page, and as I said, the program officials can help you with that. The other thing I recommend is that you want to be sure to use the assist program, the assist function, when you're going to submit an application, because it really helps you to not miss anything. And that's something that's been available in the last couple of years, but I've heard good reviews from folks that have used the assist program. Let's see, I'm looking at the budget section. So NIH has a pretty big SBIR STTR budget. Of the 27 institutes and center, the NCI is the largest, so we have about $130 million in our budget each year. So, I mean, don't necessarily want to think of applying to an institute because we have the biggest budget, but you need to think about whether or not your technology applies to the mission of a given institute, and that's kind of where you want to start. And then whether you apply for SBIR or STTR really depends on the structure of your company and whether your PI needs to be employed at an academic institution or can they be an employee of a small business, and whether or not that technology is being licensed out of a university. In those cases, you do tend to want to apply to the STTR program. I do want to give a plug for the next annual HHS SBIR conference that's coming up in Dallas in October. This is usually a three-day meeting, and we have a lot of different speakers at this conference. They'll talk to you about putting your budget together. You can speak with grants management people. You can speak with, again, program directors from the different institutes. We do a mock review so that you can understand a little bit better how the Center for Scientific Review conducts a review of your proposal. So it's a highly recommended conference, and it moves around the country, and we always do it in the fall. I'm gonna say that, I do want to also give a plug for contracts. Toward the end of the month, there's going to be a contract solicitation, And it's only under the SBIR program, so you can't have an STTR contract. But do take a look at the contract mechanism. Thank you.